Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Hello students, welcome to my second session, at my second topic for today. Before going to second topic, hope you have seen my first lesson, quadratic equation, and all the parts of the quadratic equation. Hope you understand the concept also and you are clear about the lesson. Today we are learning one of the most amazing lesson in mathematics. Why amazing? Because it is easy lesson. Why easy? Because it is very, very easy lesson. We as a students always looking for some lessons in maths where we found more calculations to score also. And one of the chapter which we are learning today is very, very interesting and everybody likes this chapter more. So before going, I will welcome myself to you. Okay, myself is Pritesh Totlikar, mathematics teacher of Sri Damodar Vidyalaya English High School, Margaon, Goa. So the lesson for today is statistics. The word statistics is very common to everyone. In our day-to-day life, we have used this word statistics. And very fond of this word because most of the things which are looking in our real life are mostly depending upon the statistics. Then what is statistics? Many mathematicians have given the definition in different ways. Some say that statistics is nothing but the science of collection, presentation, analysis, and conclusion of the data. When we come across, then what is data? So there are some basic terms or basic concepts which we'll be learning today before beginning to our new topic. So let's see what is the marks distribution of statistics chapter for your board exam. This lesson carries 6 marks. The first one is finding the mean. Under the mean, we have within 3 methods. One is direct method, one is assumed mean method, and one is step deviation method, which will carry 4 marks. Second, we will be learning finding the mode or median. That is 2 marks. And the third, we will be learning a cumulative frequency curve or Ogive curve. Now, for as you know, in maths, we again have level 1 and level 2. So for level 2 students, you'll be having the direct method under the mean and finding the mode. These are the only 2 things which we'll be learning under level 2. So let's begin with our topic today and we'll say what is statistics. I will give this statistic picture in a very simpler way to you. Not give a big definition of what this mathematician and says, a simple points which I'll give you which will make your entire definition of the statistics. As I say, statistics is nothing but collection, presentation, analysis, and conclusion of data. What is data then? A data is nothing but it is information or facts. In mathematics, it will be numerical facts or numerical figures. Let's say, take me an example, your own example. Let's say I am a headmaster or a principal of X school and I want to know the performance of my school. So what I will do is, I will ask the marks of every class. So I send my one of the assistant to every class teacher because as you know, a class teacher will have every data. So he's going to collect the data now. He reaches to a class teacher and asking the data of her class. Or maybe his class. Now you know, in a class teacher book, the record will be in a raw manner. It will not be presented in a very nice manner because it contains entire data. We want the data in a specific manner. So what the class teacher does, she may or he may present the data in the form of tables or maybe tabular forms, and she gives the data to the person who came to collect the data. So the first step, what we've done is collection. So we are done, the collection is the first one. Now once the collection is been done, the teacher also has presented the data, she has given in the tabular form, making the tables or making the forms of graphs. The person comes and gives to the headmaster. The headmaster now goes to the data. He has to see what is the performance of the student, either which class has done better or which class has not done better. What are the links or what are the things that students are lacking behind? So that is called nothing but the analysis. So he analyzes the data. He studies the data, what is the performance, how is the performance is to be done. So he analyzes the data. Finally, he has to come to conclusion. So he has to conclude that the performance of these students has done better than the last year's student, or the performance of this class is good than the other class, so he has to conclude the data. So this is in a simple way I can see a statistic that is nothing but collection, presentation, analysis, and the conclusion of the data. There are n number of examples when we can take. It may be a census, it may be finding the heights of your class, or maybe the ages of the children, maybe the performance in terms of exams. This can be different type of data. Even the TV shows, whatever, they find out the data, which is the program the majority people look. So all this data can be done with the help of this branch of mathematics, which we call as statistics. Let us come to some facts or some terms which you should know. First, as I said to you, what is data? I said to you, data is nothing but it is an information or a facts. In terms of mathematics, we'll be coming mostly numerical figures. Now, there are two types of classes. One is called grouped class, one is called ungrouped class. Let us go to we'll be learning mostly detail based on grouped classes. But everything I'll be telling the ungrouped also, so that what is the difference between the ungrouped classes and the grouped classes. Let me take one example of an ungrouped class. So can you see I have some numbers here, and if you see these numbers are very few numbers. They are not group manner. You can tell me, like for example, you say there are number 5 is repeating maybe 2 or 3 times. So you can tell this number in a very short manner. So this type of data is called ungrouped data because the data is very small. But when the data is big, we have to condense the data. We have to make in the form of tables, or we have to use some different statistical techniques so that the group can be condensed. So under grouped classes, again under group also, there are again bifurcation is there. There are again divided into two types. One you can say a discontinuous class, and one you can say a continuous class. Let us say what is the difference between the discontinuous class and the continuous class. If you look at some of the numbers here, you'll come to know actually what is I'm telling to tell you, the discontinuous and the continuous classes. If you see in a discontinuous classes, I have a class which is 1 to 10, then I have 11 to 20, 21 to 30, and so on. So in discontinuous class, there is a break. There is not a continuity, there is a break is there. So you see 1 to 10, then start from 11 to 20. Again start from 21 to 30. So there is a break in this discontinuous class. Whereas if you see in continuous classes, it is 0 to 10, then we have 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and so on. There is a continuity. That is the difference between the continuous class and a discontinuous class. We will be focusing mostly on the continuous class, not on a discontinuous class. But every discontinuous class can be made into a continuous class by some mathematical calculation. That is by adding 0.5 to the, on the right hand side, if I add 0.5, and on the left hand side, I have to subtract 0.5. What is this right hand side? What is this left hand side? I'll let you know now. Now, if you see the discontinuous class, let us say 1 to 10 or 11 to 20 or 21 to 30. The numbers which are on the left hand side, these are called limits. They are called nothing but the limits of the classes. These limits are called nothing but the lower limits. They are called as lower limits. Whereas the numbers which are on the right hand side, they are called as upper limits. Same way, if you go for the continuous classes also, the numbers which are on the left hand side, they are called as lower limits. The numbers which are on the right hand side, they are called as upper limits. So this is how we classify what are called upper limits and what are lower limits. Because these words we required in our further classes, lower limit, upper limits. So numbers which are on the left hand sides, they are called as lower limit. The number which are on the right hand side, they are called as upper limit. Then what are these called, 1 to 10 or maybe 0 to 10? These are called nothing but class intervals. They are called class intervals. Same way here also, 1 to 10, 11 to 20, they are called as class interval. Let us come to the second main concept under this, which we have learned in earlier classes, that is what is called range. Very simple term it is. Range is nothing but it is a difference between the highest and the lowest observation. Or I can say the difference between the highest and the lowest number. Let me take one example. I have a set of numbers here. 7, 10, 15, 6, 9 and 1. So these numbers I am giving, now you have to identify which is the highest number. Everyone will tell me that the highest number is 15 and the lowest number is 1. So if I subtract both this number, I will get what is called nothing but the range. And the answer of this range is 14. The second term you should know is class mark. Or in our common language, we may say midpoint. The symbol for class mark is given as XI. It is given as XI. What is class mark? If you just see the earlier limits which I took, class interval, let's say for example, I take a class interval 0 to 10. And in that 0 to 10, I had what is called upper limit, and I was knowing what is called lower limit. So formula for class mark, that is a midpoint, is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Let us take an example. I have a class 20 to 30. Let us identify the lower limit. So what is the lower limit? Yes, lower limit is 20 and upper limit is 30. Just add these both the numbers, divide by 2, you will get what is called as your class mark, and that is 25. In calculation, we don't have to show these calculations. Directly we can find out the middle point. So middle point is between 20 to 30 is what? 25. That is a middle point. If I take one more example, let's say 10 to 20. Again, identify your lower limit, identify your upper limits. So lower limit is 10, upper limit is your 20. Add, divide by 2, your class mark is 15. This we required. Class mark concept should be clear to you, because we require for every problem which we'll be learning, we require class mark or a midpoint, we say, which will be denoting as XI, will be denoted as XI. The next thing which you should know is class size or the width of the class. For example, if someone asks you how many students are there in your class, you will say I have 50 students in my class. So 50 is your class size. Similar way here also class size is there. A class interval has a size also, or we call as class width, which is given by the symbol as H. H is given as symbol as class width, and the formula of class width is upper limit minus the lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit. If you take an example, 30 to 40. So you identify the upper limit now. Upper limit is 40, lower limit is 30. So subtract both the numbers, you will get class size, that is 10. If I take one question, now let's do this question. You have to find out this. Question is, find a class mark and a class size of the following. So you have to find out the class mark also and class size. You know the formula of class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2, and the formula of class size is upper limit minus lower limit. So let's find the first class mark. So we'll add the numbers 10 plus 15 divided by 2, which will give you 12.5. Class mark can be in decimal also. It is not there every time you'll get in whole numbers. It can be in decimal. It is a middle point. So if you see middle point between 10 to 15, it is nothing but 12.5. Same way, if I take the one more, let's say for example, class size, if I find out, 15 minus 10, that is nothing but 5. If you say second example, 0 to 5, find out class mark. So if I add, I'll get, see, 2.5. So 2.5 is a middle point between 0 to 5. If I want to know class size, 5 minus 0, that is 5 is a class size of this class interval. So these are some of the basic terms or basic what I did learn before moving to our topic. One is what is called group classes. We are considering only on group classes. Second thing you should know what is called as a class size, that is given as by the symbol as H, upper limit minus lower limit. You should know what is called class mark, that is lower limit plus upper limit divide by 2, that is what is called your class mark, and what is known as range, that is highest minus the lowest. So these are some of the basic concepts of the statistics. Let us move to the first thing what we are learning today, something called as measures of central tendency. Now what is called measures of central tendency? You have heard this word common. From class 7th, you might be knowing this word measures of central tendency. And there are some of the common measures of central tendency. It is nothing but it is a value which is concentrated at the center. Means different things are there or different methods are there wherein the value is concentrating at the center. That is what is called as measures of central tendency. The three main measures of central tendency is nothing but mean, median, and mode. We will be learning this in detail. Mean, median, and mode. Under mean, we will be learning three methods which I told you. One is direct method, one is assumed mean method, and one is step deviation method. Let us understand first what is mean. All have heard the word mean, or in a simple language, we call average. We call it average. Teacher asks you, or a parent maybe ask you, what is the average of exam? So what we do, we add all the marks of every paper and we divide it by the total marks. And you get what is called nothing but average. If you just multiply by 100, you will get your percentage. So mean is nothing but average, which is given by symbol as X bar. So mean, as I say, it is a measure of central tendency which measures the middle value of a data set. So in a data set, the middle value will be getting the answer. So all it will be concentrating at that center is called a mean. Mean is calculated, a formula that is nothing but sum of all observations divided by the total number of observations. We add all the observations, we divide by the how many number of observations are there that we get the formula of a mean. That means when I said that I am adding all the observations, that means even the extreme numbers are also included. Even the extreme values, they are not ignored. In the mean, extreme values are also taken. That means all the data is given the equal importance. That I say, when I say extreme, the last and the highest, maybe least and the highest one, that is also taken in the case of mean. Let us take one situation, how to get the mean. We have two students now here, and let's say what they want to tell for us. The situation is, Parth and Harsh got marks for 5 questions. So this is a Parth and this is a Harsh. So who got marks for 5 questions? Both of them are claiming now that they have performed better. They are fighting among themselves or they are telling. Both are claiming that I am also at the same par at you only. Let's see who has performed better in exam. Now since they got the questions 5 and the teacher has given marks for these 5 questions, so I'll take the 5 marks. I'll tell the marks of Parth for you. The marks of Parth is 10, 8, 9, 8 and 7. Okay, I'll just repeat to you. It is 10, 8, 9, 8 and 7. So these are the marks of Parth. He's finding his average and he gets his average as 8.4. So you can see I just added the numbers 10 plus 8 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7. Since there are 5 questions, divide by 5 and he got his average as 8.4. Let's see why they are claiming that both have performed better. What is the difference actually? Why he said, or let's say why Harsh said that my is also same like you? Because Harsh scored the marks. He scored in one question 4. Second question he scored 7 marks. And remaining all the 3 questions he scored 10, 10 each. Full. So you can see 4, 7, 10, 10, 10. So in this case, when he got full marks in all these 3 questions, he thought that I am also at your level. And actually both are at the same level. If we total up both, one total becomes as 42 and one total becomes as 41. Just a difference of 1 mark. And his average got 8.2. You can see the average. Just a difference of 0.2 marks. But still, you can tell who has performed better. And what I can do conclusion is Parth has performed better than the Harsh. So this is how, what happened, we use the situation of mean. What type of data it is called? This is ungrouped data. Why? Because the number of observations are very less. Let us take one more situation. The second situation which I am taking is the speeds of the car. I have 6 cars. Question is, find the mean driving speed of 6 different cars Having speed, one car is 66 km per hour, second is 57 km per hour, third is 71 km per hour, fourth one is 54 km per hour, fifth one is 69 km per hour, and the last one is 58 km per hour. I want to know on the same highway, I want to know what is the average speed. So what I will do, I will add all the speed and I will divide by the 6 because there are 6 cars. And what I will get is, I will get 375 divided by 6 and the average speed of the car will be 62.5 km per hour. This is the average speed of this car. So what type of again data? This data are nothing but ungrouped type of data. So these are the simple example which you learn in your lower classes. Now we are not looking such type of example. We are going to the grouped classes. And as I told you, the first method which we will be learning today is nothing but the direct method. So we will be learning the first method under the mean, that is direct method. The formula of a direct method is mean is equal to summation fi xi divided by summation fi. You may be thinking, what is that summation, that sign which is coming here? You see that sign? What is the actually meaning of summation? Summation is nothing but it is an addition, total. As we see the problem, we'll come to know what is meant by summation. What is fi? Fi is nothing but the frequency of the ith class interval. When I say word I means it may be frequency of the first class interval, maybe second class interval, so on. Xi, we know what is xi, class mark. How we find out the class mark? Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So let's take an example. So the question is, the following table shows the marks scored by 60 students in a test. Find the mean marks scored. You have to copy this table back on your answer paper. This problem will carry 4 marks, so you have to copy back the paper entire. You see the data has been given. The marks scored, class intervals are given. You will be having the classes continuous only, 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, and 100 to 120. And the respective frequencies are given, 10, 12, 8, 14, 9, 7. The first thing what you have to do is, you have to add the total frequency. You have to add the total frequency. And I got what is called nothing but the summation fi, that is 60. You can see I added all the numbers and I got summation. That is what is called summation now. Adding all the numbers and you got total as 60. The next thing what you have to find is class mark. That is what you call as xi. How to find xi? Add this both the limits now. 0 plus 20 divided by 2. You will get what answer as 10. Every time you don't have to add. Once you know the middle point, you can even write down directly the middle point of 20 to 40 is nothing but 30, and you will get what is called as your xi. So you can see 10, 30, 50, 70, 90, and 110. So these are the middle points of this class interval, that is xi. Everything is given here, see, fi, xi. The last column tells you fi into xi. That means both you have to multiply. So what are the operation thing which are using? Addition, very common. Multiplication, very common. These are the things which should be very perfect. Simple mistake, you will lose the marks. So multiply the numbers now. 10 tens are 100. 12 thirties are, what I do mostly, I multiply 12 threes are first. I write as 36 and 10, I'll put that 0. 8 fives are 40, then 10, 400. 14 sevens are, that is 98. 10, 980, and 9 nines are 81, again 10, 810, 7 elevens are 77, 10, 770. Summation fi xi, add all these numbers, total up. So if you total up, you will get 3420. That is a total you will get, 3420. Now let me use the calculation to find out the mean now. So I will show you how to find the mean. So once you get the mean, formula you should know first. The first formula of the mean is equal to summation fi xi divided by summation fi. everything is in the table. Summation Fi Xi is 3420. And total is summation Fi is 60. Cancel this 0. Divide 342 by 6 table. So 6 ones are 6, 6 fives are 30. 34 minus 30, 4 remains, that become 42. 6 sevens are 42. So answer is 57. So this is how you can get the mean. Your answer will lie among the class interval from 0 to 120. It cannot cross more than 120. So is it clear, your first problem? That is your mean, that is summation Fi Xi divided by summation Fi. Total of the numbers, both the total, simple calculation, that is 57. If it's not getting cancellation, you can find out one decimal place. So this is the first example. This is by using direct method. Let's take the second example. So second question is, find the mean age of 100 residents of a town from the following data. This is a table. I am finding the ages of that 100 people for residing in that particular town. So class interval is given 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. The respective frequencies are also given. So what is the first thing we do? We add the total frequency. So when we add the total frequency, we'll get the total as 100. And it is given in the question also, you can see 100. So 100. Next is find the Xi, that is class mark. How to find a class mark? Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2, or directly also you can find out. Between 10 to 20, you know what is the middle number. Middle number is 15. Same way, 20 to 30, 25, 30 to 40, 35, 40 to 50, 45, 50 to 60, 65, and 60 to 70, that is nothing but 75. So you can see you got your class mark. The next is multiplication, Fi into Xi. So if you multiply, these are the numbers you'll get. Everything is actually told to you. Don't have to even by heart. What you have to do? The next step. First is telling you to find Xi, find this Xi. If you find this one column, you get one mark directly here. Second, you say, just telling you, multiply now, Fi into Xi. So multiply both the numbers. So multiply. Do the multiplication properly. That is very important. If we mix one number mistake, the entire answer will be wrong. What is the next thing we do? The next thing we add is all the numbers. That is what is called summation. So if you add this all the numbers, you will get the total as 4010, 4010. So you get this total. Once you get your summation Fi Xi and summation Fi, now we'll find out the mean. So use the mean formula again. So mean is equal to summation Fi Xi. So you write the total, 4010, divide by total summation Fi is 100. Cancel 10. Just shift the decimal place. When any number is divided by 10, 100, what you can do, you can shift the decimal place. So 10 is there. So one place shifting. So 40.1. So this is your mean. So this is the second problem by using the direct method. Very easy method, direct method here. When we mostly use direct method, now since exam we tell you, we do by direct method. But how to actually identify the methods? Direct method we mostly use when the data is also small. The numbers which are there, they are smaller numbers, not a bigger numbers. So we use mostly the direct method. So hope you are clear with the first method of the mean. This is a problem for your homework. Question is, the following table shows the marks scored by 30 students in mathematics competitive test. Find a mean mark score. So first find your total Xi, then find your summation Fi Xi. And I'll give you the answer also for you. The answer will be coming like this. So this is the first method what we have learned today. That is nothing but the mean, that is direct method. So let me entire part summarize to you first. First, what we learn what is called statistics. I have given you a clear picture of statistics. It is nothing but the, it is, first of all, it is collection of data. Second, it is a presentation of data. Third, analysis of data. And finally, conclusion of data. This data can be presented in different manners. Today, I use one of the statistical techniques, that is mean. We can even present the data in graphs or charts. You might have seen on newspaper or mostly in the TV, mostly during election, they show you the pie charts. That can be also another way of presenting the data. Then we learn there are two types of classes. One is called the continuous classes, one is called the discontinuous classes. We are concentrating on continuous classes. Under continuous classes, if I have this number only, let's say for example 10 to 25, what I said, I told you this is called all these numbers which are on the left hand side, they are called as nothing but the lower limits, and all these numbers which are on the right hand side, they are called as upper limits. Then we came what is known as a range, the highest minus the smallest, or the difference between the highest and the smallest observation. Then we came what is called as class mark, that is we find xi. How we found out xi? By adding these two limits divided by 2. Or directly also you can find out 10 plus 25 divided by 2. You can get in a whole number or you can get in decimal also. Then we learn the concept what is called class size. This will be requiring in the coming topics which we learn in class size. That is nothing but the difference between the upper limit minus lower limit. Or another way is also there, successive difference between these two limits. Maybe 25 minus 10 like this. This is called successive, consecutive, one after another. That can be also done, or a simplest method is upper limit minus lower limit. And then finally we came what is called today mean, and we discussed mean is nothing but it is the sum of all the observation divided by the total number of observation. In mean, even the extreme values are taken. Extreme values are not ignored. And the first method what we learned today is direct method, that is mean is equal to summation fi xi divided by summation fi. I told where you get summation fi, you get from here total of frequencies. Where you get summation fi xi, total of this column. And when you divide, you will get what is called mean. So this is for the today what we have learned about the mean. So thank you very much, and see you in the next class, the continuation of this statistic topic.